Hey everybody, Dr. Bob here, Facebook Live, former college football player, chiropractic intern, soon to be chiropractor in July.
Yep.
July, Tom DiCarlo from the area, coming in and hanging out with me today, and I thought it'd be a great idea for us to have a conversation. As you can see, Tom played football. You were a
running back.
You played offense then, obviously.
Yep.
I thought you were a linebacker. That was in high school.
A little bit of both, running back and linebacker.
Okay, great. So we have him here, former college football player. Let's talk about concussion. Did you get any?
Couple, definitely one diagnosed.
I noticed that.
My sophomore year, was just coming through the hole, got hit inside of the head, and went black for a little bit. We went over the impact sport testing, and
okay.
I was diagnosed with concussion.
So you had the impact. So impact is a great test. We strongly recommend the impact test. It's something that they take in high schools, like you probably took it, you're not that long out of high school, you're a young guy, not like me, and they take the impact and you have impact pediatric. Some other tests they have now is called the SCAT. They got the SCAT 3, which is I think 12 and under, and SCAT 5, which is 13 and older, and the other test that we like that I've used a lot, which you can download, is the King DVAC test by the Mayo Clinic. So you got the concussion. So they actually do test for concussions in college.
Yep.
Terrific. What was your treatment protocol like?
There really wasn't much that we were able to do in the training room. Mm-hmm. It was really almost just a waiting process for us there.
Rest
and, you know, just stay in a dark room. Mm-hmm. There wasn't much that we could do, which was frustrating. And, you know, it took 2 weeks to clear up before you go back to playing. And, you know, it's difficult.
Wow. So the reason I'm talking to Tom is we were going through it and we were amazed in the different chiropractic protocols that we have now that we're implementing in the office and lecturing on nation and worldwide. So one of the things I said to him, and he knows it, is that rest is no longer an option with a concussion. As soon as you get back to active care, doesn't mean he should put his helmet on and go ram into somebody, you know, as a fullback, a blocker, a linebacker, or whatnot, but rest is not an option. We found that steady state, the literature dictates that steady state exercise is by far the best. And also high intensity interval training. As long as the symptomology, you know, you're not regurgitating or getting dizzy, is the option. There was a new article that came out last week that said that after an acute injury, that if you started to exercise and rehab on day 2 versus day 9, you save 3 weeks in treatment over the duration of that treatment program. So rest. You had a concussion. Any nutrition?
We didn't address that at all.
Okay, so we've talked about that before, the nutrition, magnesium L-threonate, what a great choice. Magnesium L-threonate passes the blood-brain barrier, goes into the brain. 9 to 14 years, it takes off aging on damage to the brain. It also increases magnesium in the cerebrospinal fluid by 50%, and also increases magnesium in the brain by 15%. Glutathione, omega-3 fatty acids. Were you taking omega-3s at the time?
At the time,
all right, so you probably responded a little quicker.
Yeah.
Than everybody else, your other colleagues.
A lot of people were out for the whole year.
The whole year. That's amazing. So here he's talking about a concussion that he got for 2 weeks, because the data is very robust on omega-3s. It talks about you won't get as bad a concussion and you'll get back quicker if you took it before the injury. Any rehab?
We really didn't do any rehab with it, just basic, you know, getting back into moving before having symptoms, but in terms of that.
Wow. So we all know about the rehab, we know a lot about the eye movement, head and eye movement. Dr. Ted Carrick has done a great choice, something that you may want to consider. We're talking about that, in that we do a lot of vestibular increasement in movement, and that eye-head movement is a critical element. You know, the eyes are not only the soul of your body, but they also enable you to really look inside mechanistically at what's going on in somebody's body. You're studying to be a chiropractor, right?
Yeah.
Concussion, does it excite you?
Very much so. It's something that you don't realize every day people deal with it, whether it be a car accident, a slip and fall. It's not something that's just athletes, but we also do have a huge athletic population that we work with, and it's great to see how it can impact everybody. So.
Absolutely. He's so right about the concussion and everything. You got a little question. Go for it.
Question came in. Dr. R. Curtis asks, that treatment time
hey, Curtis.
Change...
What's up? It's raw. I'm sorry, Dan. I'll repeat this question. I'm giving Dan a hard time. He's having a rough day, man. He knocked my coffee over. I mean, it's just been rough. Good.
Okay. So, Dr. Ralph asks, that treatment time change in resisting activity is novel for sure. Is it age dependent?
Great question. Yes, I know Tom is young and he's very powerfully built. I'm a little older and a little different physique at the point. The study was with non-athletes and athletes, they got back much quicker. Here's what I'll say. I think the stronger and better shape that somebody is, they respond better to any kind of stimuli, any kind of chiropractic treatment, which speaks to the concept I tell everybody. Chiropractic isn't just a reactive type of doctor. We are a proactive doctor. And if you had to take one pearl from hanging out, you understand that. If we're waiting to the injury,
it's too late.
It's too late. Because now they're injured. Let's avoid some injuries. So I hope I answered that question. Do we have another one or?
No, you can keep going. We'll have
You got a couple more coming in? Great. So that was a good question. Did you respond because you're in better shape than the other guys? Were the guys fit?
I would think so. I mean, even though everybody's in athletic shape,
right.
I definitely, from having the science background more than other people, was always good to be taking my fish oils and really careful about my diet and exercise to begin with. Whereas some people would just show up and play. And those guys definitely had a tougher time getting back from any injury, let alone something as serious as a concussion.
Yeah. Any of you guys couldn't play the rest of their college career because of concussions?
We had a couple people that had them and they couldn't get past the impact testing again, or even when they would return to play, immediately we're getting another one and another one, and you know, it comes a point where you have to stop.
Secondary impact is a big play. So, you know, we talk about concussion being the most complex injury in the body with the most intricate organ, your brain, but the secondary impact is so deleterious. So that's the biggest thing. You want to exercise, you just don't want that second concussion. And I mean, you play Division III, so it's very competitive, but it's not like maybe like Georgia and Alabama last night where they were a little bigger and really banging on each other. So, you know, football's a great sport. Soccer, females are the number one concussion sports. We don't want to stop people from playing sports. We just want to prepare them. So if you have any questions, I know Dan's got a couple over there. If you have any questions, feel free to ask us. Please do me a favor. We do this every week. We're growing. We love spreading the health word. Tom will be in a whole bunch of these in the future with me. Like, click, and share. Like, click, share, comment. If you have any questions, email me. Dan, I think you gave me the...
Yes. Testing. You mentioned before two tests, impact and SCAT. If you can go a little bit more into those tests.
Sure. Well, why don't you tell them about the impact test since you took a whole bunch of them?
So at least for the impact test with us, it was a computer-based test where you see an image or a word, and basically off of your reaction time, they establish a baseline of where your cognitive function usually should be at and how your synapses usually fire at whatever rate they may be at. And they compare that after a suspected injury or a known injury to see if you're back to that level that you normally should be functioning at.
And the SCAT is a very similar exam. They're all cognitive, number naming, single letters. Those were two. The QDVAC is something you take on your iPad. Dan, who you can't see right now, he's holding the camera over there. He has a sixth grade, am I correct?
Sixth grade.
So he knows to have that QDVAC test. You put it right on your iPad, you open it up. It's rapid, single. Numbers, it's just testing your cognitive input. In my office, believe it or not, I like Tandem Gate. Now Tandem Gate, you go to Tandem Gate. So Tandem Gate, real simply, he's gonna stand there and I'm right in front. Tandem Gate. So just walk. It's walk the straight line like they used to if you were drunk, and if you can't, that's an issue. We we'll usually drop a little piece of paper down or a string and see if they can walk on the string. Again, you'll see any kind of cardinal fields of gaze if they're not able to have that. If I'll do this and they start getting dizzy, that's a real good idea that they, you know, they got popped and they need to get tested. So the testing is great. You can do it on your own. You can do it right there. The biggest problem, there was a new study that just came out that only a third of high school coaches, parents, and athletes understood what a concussion was and understood that it was, you ready for this? Do we have another one?
Yes, which you may have just touched on. What is in first aid is in quotes. What's a first aid test that can be done like right there on the side?
I think the first aid test, the best thing is if you can't pop open and go to the King DVAC, you can just take a cardinal field of gaze. And if he can't follow my eyes, or your child, boy or girl, can't follow your eyes, they've probably got popped. Take them out. It's always better when in doubt, sit them out is what I go by. Do you have a couple more?
So that was first aid, and what about the first couple of hours after?
Well, the interesting thing is, here's the big thing, and I get hit on this. The literature says, like when I grew up, it said, don't let them go to sleep. We now know that they can go to sleep as long as they don't have any brain type damage or any bleeding. A lot of people get uptight about that, but they can't. So that's a great choice to allow them to relax. If get them up and moving, get them on the bike. As long as they're not regurgitating and they have this type of symptomology, get them moving.
Okay. That's it for now.
Okay, guys. So once again, I want to thank you a lot. I really appreciate you coming. Like, click, and share. We got another question.
Yes, something came in from Christina F. My 12-year-old daughter competing in show jumping on highest level crashed and went into a coma 5 hours, 4 months ago.
Wow.
After using the Arconia PL Touch morning and night, she didn't have any headache. And I'm sorry, from there, it just...
Okay, so the Arconia PL Touch, no problem. Everybody knows I'm an Arconia guy. The laser's outside, so Nick will follow up with a couple of pictures. Dan, we'll punch those pictures up. Mm-hmm. Arconia laser, FDA cleared for decreased pain and increased range of motion. I've used it extensively in concussion. I only not only use the PL Touch, I use the FX635, I also use the EVRL. All these lasers are critical. The literature is robust in that a 635 laser, just like Arconia, which very low power, 17.5 milliwatts, has shown to increase the healing at the brain level. Stroke, concussion. If anybody's truly interested in my concussion protocol, why don't you like this? Say I'm interested, and I will go through the concussion protocol sometime by next week on another Facebook Live. Do we have any other questions?
That's it.
Please share the information. If you have any questions, you can IM, DM me. Dr. Rob, always yours in health.